children. I hope you might be safe at your homes. So today is a wonderful day. Stay positive and love and respect your family. At the same time, eat healthy, boost your immune system to save yourself against this COVID-19. Okay? And at the last but not the least, don't panic. Now, so I've come here with another poem, that is The Invention of Shoes, in your book of class 8, that is Roots. So The Invention of Shoes is a poem which is written by Rabindranath Tagore. As we all know, as we all have heard about Rabindranath Tagore, that he was a poet, musician and an artist. He is best known for writing the national anthem, which we all sing in the school. Okay, now, so the poem is all about a king whose name is Hobu. Okay, there was a king named Hobu who told his minister Gobu that he had been impatient and thinking all night that why his feet should be dirty by soil wherever he step on the ground. Now let's read the lines. Said good King Hobu to Minister Gobu, I have pondered all night. Is it just that whenever my feet should land on the street, they come to be sullied by dust? Your wages you draw, but you don't care a straw. To serve the demands of the king, it's a rank plot to foil me, my own soil to soil. I simply won't stand such a thing. Unless you can find a solution, you're all doomed to swift dissolution. So here, the king is saying that I have thought throughout last night that why should my feet become dirty with dust as soon as I put my feet on the earth. And he's also asking his minister that you only draw your salaries without caring about your duties to the king. And at the same time, he says that I am the king and my own land dares to dirty my foot. What nonsense is this? He's simply disgusted. The king is simply frustrated. And at the last, he says that I want you soon to find. He orders his minister to find the remedy of his solution, otherwise he shall spare none of them. Now, after that, what happens? The terrified minister, at these words, minister, broke into cold sweat with fright. The pundits grew pale and the courtiers once hail, lay sleeplessly tossing all night. In the minister's home, There was weeping and gloom. The fires in the kitchen grew cold, till crazed with fears, his beard drenched in tears, he fell at the king's feet and told, but how can we live if denied the dust from your feet sanctified? So he says that stanza, the courtiers became panicked. Okay, why did they become panic? They became panic after the king proclaimed such a terrible order. What was that order like? Order was he would not find solution to the king's problem, then the ministers would be sentenced to death. Now, he says that, and even the highly respected pundits, they all grew pale and other courtiers, they lost their sleep after this order of the king. They were not able to sleep. Why were they not able to sleep, children? They were not able to sleep because the king's order appeared to be an impossible task, which filled them with extreme fear. And what happened after that? They were not only scared, but they also lost their meals. They closed their kitchens, okay, they stopped taking their meals. All of them began to cry. Why did they begin to cry? They began to cry out of fear. And the minister Gobu, he was so terrified by the king's proclamation that all his beard was awashed with tear. He started crying. At last, he said to his king that how shall he get the dust off his feet if they never became dirty at all. He told that if your feet remain dust free, then how we will get the dust off your holy feet? He said to the king. Now come to the next page, let's see. Now at this, what does the king says? That's a question indeed, King Hobu agreed, but maybe should come after must. We need to discourse on this problem of yours, but meanwhile get rid of the dust. You are getting good money, I don't think it funny. You can't tackle problems like these. There seems little point why I should appoint these scientists with long degrees, so deal with the first things first, or else be prepared for the worst. Thus royally chided. Okay, so here the king this made when the court, when the minister said that as in the previous page we had read that the king, the minister, okay, he just questioned the king that if the dust will be removed, if your feet will be dust free, then how will get the dust off your holy feet? Now at this, the king made king seriously think. Okay, he started thinking seriously, but what did he say? He said at last that yes, it is true. I agree with your statement. You are correct, but first you remove the dust, and thereafter you can theorize about the dust of my feet. Okay, पहले आप dust हटाओ और तब हम बाद में बात करेंगे कि मेरे feet की dust, holy dust का क्या होना है, क्या होता है. If this poses a problem and you cannot solve, then you get your salaries from nothing. He says that अगर if you cannot solve this problem of making my feet dust free, then you people are just taking salary for nothing. And he also says that why did I employ so many scientists, ministers, scientist servants holding so many degrees? He says that if you are not able to tackle my problem, then why have I appointed you people? Why have I appointed such well-educated staff of mine? He also says that you finish your work first and then think about the other things later. Other things means other things, he meant to say the dust of his holy feet. Now what happened after that, children? After that, he says, after that, poor Gobu decided to call the wise men of the land. Each subtle mechanic was summoned in panic. They studied and brooded and scanned. With spectacles perched on the nose, they researched as they took 19 barrels of snuff, then warned if the crust of the earth lost its dust. You couldn't grow food grains enough. So he says that why, what are you wise men worth? Said the king. Can't you tackle the dirt? After some more decision, they found a solution, which was to buy millions of brooms. The king couldn't breathe, for the dust from the street was driven right into his rooms. The people that passed were blinded with dust. They coughed and they sneezed in a daze. The dust floated down and veiled all the town. The sun disappeared in the haze. So here the king, he asked the minister to find the problem of he asked the minister to find the solution of his problem first, and then he can think about the other things later. Now when king said that, so Gobu he just called all the wise and intelligent pandits were called, okay, and he Gobu the minister got utterly confused, okay, and he carefully began to recruit the learned and the technologists from far and near. They all, after that what happened, they all sat down with their spectacles on
and they used up 19 drums of snuff. So 19 barrels of snuff, what do you mean, tobacco. Okay, they were so much stressed out that how much did they use the snuff, children? They used 19 drums of tobacco, snuff. They thought and came up with the solution. So finally, what happened? They came up with the solution. And what was the solution like? If the soil is removed, we will grow our... Okay, so now again there was a problem. They wanted the crust of the earth lost its dust. You couldn't grow food grains enough. Why? The minister said that if the crust means soil, okay? So if the soil is removed from the earth, then where will they grow their crops? Now at this again, the king is saying that if you cannot do that, then why so many pundits are there? Okay, if you cannot tackle problem, then what are you people for? Now, what happened? After some more discussion, they found a solution, which was to buy millions of brooms. The king couldn't breathe, for the dust from the street was driven right into his rooms. The people that passed were blinded with dust. They coughed and they sneezed in a daze. The dust floated down and veiled all the town. The sun disappeared in the haze. So together they deliberated. Okay, they thought and bought millions of brooms. Now what are they going to do with the brooms? Let's see. They swept so hard that the dust of the streets covered the entire body of the king. Okay, and what happened? The men began to cough, and to remove the dust, the king said that they have covered the whole world with dust. Now, because of too much of dust, none could open their eyes. Okay, none could know. All the ministers, they started sneezing and coughing. And behind the clouds of dust, the sun itself was lost. The sun itself got disappeared. You see the last line, the city became invisible. Why did the city become invisible? The city became invisible due to dust. The entire dust from the land was swept so hard that it all got it all went into the king's room, and king also started sneezing and coughing. Okay, so it was a kind of problem. Again, there was another problem for the king now. So after this, what happens? So that I shall tell you in the next video. Okay, so till then, read this poem again and try to understand the underlying meaning of the poem. Till then, stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you, children.